Okay, this is just a quick video about steroid culture in the UK. I mean, let's say in the world.
What the hell is this?
I've been around the fitness industry since I was like 17. Lost weight when I was 20. Lost weight when I was 18. Lifted for like 3 months and then I quit. Became a runner, then I had an operation, then I quit fitness altogether. So I was probably up to the age of 22 and I was fat. Then I started getting back in shape again. Now, previous to when I was 22, steroids were very elitist. They were denied big time by everyone, even by pro bodybuilders, male models. Steroids was like, how dare you? How dare you even bring up steroids? You know, what are you talking about? That is what steroids was like. You know, you go up to Ronnie Coleman and say, hey, you're on steroids. Ronnie Coleman would turn around and say, no, I'm natural. And people would believe it back then. You'd believe that the guy standing up on the stage are all natural. Of course, if you study a sports science degree or anything like that, and you read into it, you realize that these men are past human limits. But let's jump forward a few years. When I was 22, let's say just before 22, was very much, steroids were unheard of. Steroids were seen as the guys down the gym covered in spots, looked like crap. They were on steroids, and these guys were having heart attacks and dying. And it was like, whoa, if you're on steroids, you're going to have a heart attack. 2 years and you're gonna drop dead and you're gonna lose all your hair. And now everyone understands how many people are on steroids. It's acceptable. You wanna get in front of a magazine, you have to take steroids. You wanna stand on stage and win gold, you have to take steroids. You wanna win the 100 meter sprint, you have to take steroids. You wanna be a boxing champion, you have to take steroids. You want to be a swimming champion, you have to take steroids. Anything that involves a human body, if you want to become the best at it, you have to take fucking steroids. Now, why am I talking about this? Because everyone now knows about this.
Correct.
So I've got this stupid iPad. So now I'm 26. Steroid culture is massively popular. I would say in gyms. In good gyms, there are probably more steroid users now than there are non-steroid users. To the point where the small guys are on steroids. And if they're not on steroids, then they are asked to go on steroids. Now, I'm not hating on any of this. I was kind of lucky because I had a home gym. What is with this light, mate?
Yeah, this is still me.
I had a home gym. I had no influence with my training. I just sat in a room for a couple years lifting. And that's how I got my body. I got bored of that, and now I'm in gyms. I see things. I see people. You know, I've studied this for years now. I've studied this. But it's got to the point, this is the point of the whole video, 4 minutes in, where now I am considered a steroid user because of how I look. Because steroids are so well known, because steroids have brought up so much and so many people are taking steroids. Now I am considered a steroid user, and that is the point that I was getting to. It's done a full 360. It's gone from being unknown, it's gone from being how dare you even talk about this thing, to now if I would go into a gym and I lift 140 fucking 2 kilos on the bench and people look at me, they're like, this guy's on fucking steroids. And they'll come up to me. I've had it. 2 people have asked me, what are you taking? I'm straight. I'm not taking nothing. So then they change and then they say, what supplements do you take? And I say, what supplements I take, brother? Multivitamin. That's what I take. And then they say, well, what else do you take? I say, I eat chicken. And broccoli and a few egg whites. And cod liver oil in the fridge. And they're like, man, they can't believe it because their mate, they's on steroids and has been lifting for 2 years, is smaller than me, but I'm bigger than his mate on steroids, so I'm on steroids. That is the fucking problem. And if you're someone now, if you're a lifter, and you're going into a gym, you're surrounded by people on steroids, everyone's on steroids, the small guy's on steroids, so the big guy's on steroids, you have to go on steroids, right? That's going to be your mentality, and then there's going to be 19-year-olds juiced up. I see it in my own eyes, I see these 19-year-olds juiced up. Some people respond well, some don't. Some people are covered in spots, some people stay small, some people get sold fake stuff. And yeah, would I like to go on steroids? Yeah, I would. I would love it. But why don't I? I've been doing this for so long. I feel like that if I did, I feel like I would just be a part of the crowd. I would be nothing to be. I would be happy with myself, but I've been natural for bloody 4 years now. I don't know. I just don't know. It's strange. It's strange. When you change, when all of a sudden you've been natural for 4 years and you're lifting naturally and you're gaining slowly and slowly and slowly. I don't know. Would I like to be bigger? Not really. Would I like to be leaner? Yeah. The conditioning of people on steroids is unbelievable. You have to be honest. But I'm aging as fuck. I'm aging quick. 26, I look old. So me on steroids, I don't know, man. I'll probably lose all this hair and look in my mid-40s. But that's what I'm saying. Don't accuse everyone of steroids. Don't accuse everyone that you see of steroids, because there are people like me out there that have lifted for 4 years. And we don't take it. Don't accuse us. If you see some guys with some traps, and those traps are fucking enjoying me. Been there for 2 years and